or tomorrow, you can connect with Quantum Healing. I offer potent energy healing sessions. These include 24 hours of energetic support unless you choose to level up, which adds 3 days to any healing session. And I work on releasing the root causes of why your body is having this imbalance. And just this morning, I was asking my body, and this has to do with weight, and I'm going to get really personal about my weight journey with you right soon here. You really want to hear the DL for me getting raw and real. It's coming. But I was working on the reasons why the weight is not balanced in my body. And guess what? Hydration played a role. Was my body's hydration and utilization of electrolytes properly aligned to support the physical vessel that I am desiring to anchor into? And I got a big no, and there were some important things that I had to release. Curses from my mother. Oh, thank you. Love it. Let's pile those on. The reason I'm so powerful at my energy work is thanks to my mother, this earthly vessel that birthed me. Everything that she has deployed against me in my life has taught me to be very strong. And so thank you for helping me be the strong healer that I am today. And so hydration, it's really the key to our healing journey. We've talked about water consciousness before, where water literally is consciousness. It's pure consciousness, and you can program it however you want. So are you drinking death water or monster water energy drinks? Guess what you're programming into your body, that energy. Or are you drinking water that is aligned with positive, beneficial healing energies? Words, thoughts, intentions matter, not only for the physical water that you are drinking, but for the water that is inside of your vessel, which if you are properly hydrated, could be up to 80% of your being water. And so if you're thinking thoughts, what are you programming with your thoughts into your water? Very important. Very key, something that most overlook in their healing journey, but it's truly the foundation. So if you're ready to come back to the foundation, balance your body's ability to utilize and integrate water and electrolytes into your body. This session also includes, I think, 4 or 5 different energies of supplements that I add energetically to support your body in healing and being able to use water and electrolytes. That in itself is the value of the whole session, just the energies that I'm adding in the session for you, in addition to all the balancing and clearing. So connect with this if you're really ready to do some root level foundational physical body work. Hydration is your number one session for that. The key, the foundation. All right, let's go into weight walls. This is always a popular session. I could make bank selling you weight loss products. The number one session that I always have for my energies of supplements has to do with weight walls or weight. People who are not happy with their weight, they want to lose weight, they want a quick, easy fix. And so if I launched a product, which I've had several people approach me trying to get me to push their product on you, and know that I will never sell out. If I'm bringing a product, it means it's tested and vetted to the core, and I truly stand behind it. There is no amount of money. I'm just saying this for all the parasites out there trying to get me to buy into their programs to leech money from you under false pretenses. I'm not going to sell out, and I'm not going to sell these products that are corrupt at the core. Products that at the core, maybe you will lose weight, but that are causing harm for you and are not for your highest good. And so that I'm going to get honest about my weight loss journey, my healing with this. Because I have not chosen this time to take the easy way out. My whole life, I have actually not struggled with weight, more so probably putting on weight because I had Hashimoto's thyroiditis, and it was diagnosed right when I was getting out of college, when I finally started being able to go to the doctor by myself. And then I ended up with all these diagnoses within 5 to 10 years. I had 20 diagnoses. For, you know, you're sick and these are all the reasons why everything's wrong in your body. Of course, they never diagnosed Lyme or Bartonella or Babesia or Epstein-Barr or mold sickness, all which were also impacting my body. But in college, I was 92 pounds and I thought I was overweight. I hated my body my entire life. And I realized why. Last night, Trent and I have been trying to connect with each other physically for a while now, and we end up going into healing, emotional or spiritual healing instead. And I feel so loved and supported by this man. He's incredible. I've never felt so loved and supported in my whole life. And it's just, I was getting really emotional this morning thinking about how loved I feel by him. But our ability to receive love happens within first. If we can't receive love within ourselves, we won't be able to receive it from someone else or really feel it. And I've been working to feel his love, and I struggle with that, honestly. And he can feel my energy and my love, like it's amazing for him. He can't get enough of it. And this is just my energy field, but I can't feel his. What does it have to do with? It connects into weight balance for me. When I was growing up, I grew up in a home that was extremely toxic, extremely shame-based, with narcissists, covert narcissists, overt narcissists, you name it. I was surrounded, aunts, uncles, grandparents, parents, siblings, all around me. Not that I'm a victim. I chose to be born into this for training so I could become who I am today. And I'm still shifting and changing. But a trick of the narcissist and low vibration beings is to give you subtle words or phrases to break down your self-worth. And so from the time that I was just a little child, this perfect, beautiful child, I heard things like, why is your belly so big? You have a poochy belly. What's wrong with your ears? They stick so far out of your head. What's wrong with you? And so I grew up thinking that all of these things were wrong with me. I was so self-conscious about my ears that I had these horrible monkey ears that were sticking off of my head. I was so conscious of my belly that was this pot belly, according to my dad. And I still carry those imprints in my body. What things have people said to you that have become embedded in your psyche? And so when you try to connect with healing for weight balance or whatever it is, there's this phrase in your head that says, not you. It's never going to work for you. You're inherently flawed. There's something really wrong with you at the core. Nothing is ever going to work for you. You're beyond repair. These are all false core beliefs that we get built into our body that start programming our vessel, our water, who we are. And so when we try to connect with something like quantum healing or a healthier diet or working out, and then you have this phrase saying, that's never going to work for me. That's not going to work. You're the exception. It's just too much. You have too much going on. Do you think we're going to be able to overcome and really connect with healing until we clear out these mental programs and blockages? No. Yes, you can go take this simple way. You can take pills, surgeries, injections for weight loss. That is no different than cutting out your appendix when it starts to have problems or your gallbladder. Oh, it has problems. Let's just cut it out. Your stomach, you're eating too much. Let's just cut off half of your stomach. Staple it. Take these injections so your body can't utilize and absorb any of your nutrients. But at the core, we are not addressing the root cause problem of why we are imbalanced in our weight to begin with. And most likely, it has to do with some of these false core beliefs. Most likely, it has to do with trauma. I want you to think about if you've been, you know, had weight balance in your life, and then you went where you started gaining weight, what was the catalyst for that moment? I was reflecting this morning on mine, and I have not really had weight issues my whole life, other than I always thought I was fat. I had anorexia and bulimia in high school because of all of these programs from all of my family. And then I was Miss Teen Montana when I was 16. So all of this pressure to make me look better and good because my natural self wasn't good enough. I remember getting a photo shoot for the pageant. I had never done a pageant before. Just part of me decided to do it one day, heard it on the radio, and I felt horrible about myself growing up in this home of toxic people and shame, and you're a piece of trash and worthless. And I don't know what in me was brave enough to actually sign up and do it. And I had to go and get sponsorships around town and ask people to sponsor me. And they did, because my own family was not very supportive. And I knew that they wouldn't just like say, here's the money to go do the pageant. They gave me a little bit. My mom did go buy me a dress and a swimsuit. And my grandpa gave me some money. But most of it, I had all these sponsors. In the book, I had like pages of sponsors. And everyone else just had their parents pay for it. So that was my journey. And I went to get my first photo shoot. And the director that was running the Montana pageant, and she was from Colorado and ran all these other pageants, and this was all new to me. She's like, oh, I hired this, you know, special makeup artist and these high-class people to come and fix you for your photo shoot. And it was a surprise reveal. And I was 16 and I looked like a hooker. No offense if that's what you do. But I looked like I was 35. I did not look like myself at all. And the message that that gave to me was, you're not good enough the way you are. We have to completely change you and to look like somebody that you are not to be good enough to do this. And so think of all that programming that happened to my little 16-year-old body who was already struggling with shame and feeling good enough and thinking that everything was wrong with me. And then all of these girls, seeing them at pre-pageant events, and then for the main pageant, looking completely different. Their hair was bleached, they had on these fake lashes, they had all these spray tans, they had in fake teeth, like nothing was the same. And I complained about my photos, and she got pissed. And then she pulled me out of the pageant right after we did a workout, and like, you're going in to do your pictures now. And so my pictures, my final pictures, I had nothing. It was just like, you're going to get nothing and I'm going to make you pay for it because you dared to speak up that you didn't want to look like a 35-year-old hooker at 16. And so there, I was dealing with all of these like parasite energies coming at me as a 16-year-old girl. And when Trent was working on me last night, he found that I still had trauma from this in my body of not feeling good enough and that I'll never meet these standards. And this makes me emotional for our girls and for you, because everywhere we look, magazines, movies, everything is fake. It's all photoshopped and edited, and none of these are real people. And so our culture is trying to put us in this standard to never accept yourself for who you are and that you're never good enough. And no matter what you do, you're never going to be pretty enough or have the perfect body or look good enough. And then we start to internalize that, and it starts corrupting us in the core and dimming our light, when inside you are this beautiful light being. And how do we get our internal to reflect to the external? I spent quite a time this morning trying to work on that for this session, the weight wall session. Like, how do we get this to really connect in? But it starts with our emotions first. And so I never actually had weight issues until, I probably don't. I feel like I'm probably a healthy weight now, right now where I'm at. But when I lost my daughter Grace to miscarriage, and this was in 2018, when I first started, she was a catalyst. Losing Grace was a catalyst for my healing journey. After I lost her, I gained, I think, 15 or 20 pounds. It was heavier than I had ever been in my life. And I ended up doing HCG injections through my naturopath. And they did work. But my stomach and my whole body got very sick. I started throwing up to the point where I couldn't go. I had to carry a bucket with me. I was vomiting throughout the day. And my stomach was so imbalanced and I was so sick. But I lost the weight. At what cost to my body, right? Like, are we doing things and not really caring about the long-term effects on our body? And this was a wake-up call for me. And so the one thing that saved me, and I recommend this to a lot of clients, is Anthony William has a book called Liver Rescue. And he has a liver rescue detox. And I did that. And by day 4, I stopped throwing up and my body started to find balance within itself again. And prior to the HCG diet, I wasn't eating meat. I had stopped eating meat quite a few years ago. I used to do paleo since 2012, and I did the Lyme diet trying to get healthier and healed. And my body said, stop, you need to stop all of this. And my naturopath, he was in the Olympic trials for wrestling as a vegetarian. And he's like, apes and monkeys are these giant, muscular, strong beings, and they only eat fruits and veggies and bugs. And they're on a plant-based kind of pescatarian diet. And he told me the reason my hormones were so imbalanced was because I was replacing my natural hormone production in my body with artificial animal hormones. Even if you get the most organic meats, the meat itself has hormones because the animal itself has hormones. So if you're eating eggs or meats, you're getting those animal hormones. And what it does to our bodies is we start relying on those fake artificial hormones that are not human to fill in the gaps. And our body stops producing hormones because we're getting all of these influx of animal proteins and hormones. And so our body will just stop producing them on our own. That could relate to other areas of your life too. If you just keep getting everything, you're going to just stop. Your body is going to say, well, I don't need this anymore. And this is a reason why people going on these high protein, animal-based, carnivorian diets feel so good because they're overloading their system with all of these hormones. And guess what? In the long run, your body's going to stop producing hormones, and then you're going to have to keep on the animal proteins, or you're going to feel horrible. And for you to really get your body back in balance, you need to go through a detox, which I did, and it took me probably, let me ask my body, 6 months of being off animal proteins, which included dairy, for my body to start producing my own hormones again. And before that, I was on thyroid hormone, I was on progesterone, I was on DHEA, which is a precursor to testosterone, because my body wasn't producing any hormones. And it was on all these supplements and all these medications. Now I take none of it. Now I don't even need any of that because my body is balanced and harmonized and it's producing its own human hormones. I'm not replacing with animal hormones. So that is a placebo. Not really a placebo, but it's a cover up. It's like taking an aspirin to cover up your headache by taking animal proteins to fix your hormone issues. It's not a long-term solution at the core so that your body is functioning within its own unit, free of all of these other energies. That is the goal with the work that I want to do for you or support you on, is to bring ourselves back to wholeness in the core of our being so we don't need all of these supplements. We don't need to eat these certain foods to feel good because our body is already good and balanced within ourselves. So after I lost Grace, I gained the weight and I lost it through HCG. Was it worth it? No. Because all that did, again, was a cover-up for the trauma that happened to me. I hear so many times after someone passed away, I started gaining this weight. After this happened to me, this trauma, I started gaining weight or losing weight. We can have the opposite too, or we can't put weight on our bodies. The session Weight Walls is about finding balance within that. Maybe you want to be 105 pounds, but is that for your highest good of your body? Is your inner child aligned with that? We have to make sure our whole self is aligned with what we're working on. And a lot of times, our outer self is running the marathon, and our little one, our inner child, is left in the dust. And we forgot about them. And they have all these traumas and areas that they need support and to work through so that they can catch up. Don't leave part of yourself behind in this journey. Don't sacrifice your physical health for a temporary solution to a root problem. So after I got my weight back in balance, I then became pregnant with Briella in 2018. No, 2020. I became pregnant with Briella. And I was like, I just saw this picture that came up today. I don't know if I could find it. I was like, I thought I was fat. You guys, this is like the problem with this mental ish, these mental issues. I'm like, how could I have thought that? I was pregnant. And she was due in 6 months. And I looked like Nothing. Like you couldn't even tell that I was pregnant. And I was like, oh, my little bump's starting to show. After I gave birth to her, I assumed that my body would go right back. Being 40, having a baby, they're like, oh, it's not the same. It's not. In my late 20s, I gave birth to my son. And by the time I left the hospital, I was already wearing my pre-pregnancy shorts. Like it just went right back. And then with my daughter, I ended up gaining, I am now 20 pounds heavier than before I gave birth to her. I am heavier now than when I was actually pregnant with her before I gave birth to her. And so I've been struggling with this weight issue. I don't like the way my body looks right now. And I don't want to go to the cheap cop out where I'm going to go to HCG or some injection or some plan that doesn't align to my body. I tried the body balancing drops, which we've talked about those, and my body shut down. It said, F this. This is not good. It wasn't the drops, it was the diet. But the drops don't work unless you're doing the diet, which is toxic for my body. And my body said no. And I started feeling those same feelings of when I was on HCG. And my friend who does zoonology reminds, she goes, this feels like you're on HCG again. Your body is like not doing good. And so I quit. And I have dedicated myself to doing this the root cause way. So it may take longer, which is frustrating. We want that instant quick fix, and I just want it now. And I don't care the cost to my body as long as it looks good. But does it matter if it feels good or it's really good? And how are you going to keep the weight off 2 years from now? Are you going to stay on the toxic injections or pills for life until your liver fails or your heart starts shutting down? What are you going to do? Ozempic eats your muscle, which your heart is a muscle. Does it matter? Would you rather die to beauty or start to accept yourself for who you are and deal with the root? I do have an amazing testimonial from one of my clients about the weight wall session. And she actually gave two testimonials over time. And I don't get a lot of testimonials on this one. People just don't share. And so I have close to 1,000 reviews from people, and I don't ask, they just share. So thank you if you do share. But here's one from Linda. She says, I've lost 13 pounds. I was never able to lose weight like this before, but after taking your weight wall session, it changed things, and I'm so grateful for that. Thank you, Linda, for sharing. This one is a two-part review from Alana. She said, the past few weeks, I have dropped 11 pounds, and one of my main goals was and still is weight loss. Later, she said, in 2023, I actually dropped 55 pounds. I have done the weight wall session 3 times. My diet is less restrictive. I have increased my caloric intake and was able to enjoy more things with sugar, not less. I still have about 20 pounds to go until I reach my goal. So that is the goal with this, is to release the root cause of why your body is putting on weight. And I truly feel at the core, I should be able to eat a generally balanced, healthy diet and take care of my body by doing like some workouts, but not killing my body with cardio and have balance in my body and look great without taking supplements or all of these toxic things. I feel that is possible. I am working on that for you. I'm working on it for me. And part of my healing journey has been to overcome so many blocks and imbalances. By overcoming them in myself, I learn how to support others on their healing journey. And part of the reason that I carried all of this extra weight in my abdomen and I still have it, like if my belly would go away, I would be happy with my body. I look like I'm 6 or 7 months pregnant. How I feel. Like, I don't like it at all. But I was severely abused as a child, sexually. Horrific things happened to my body. And where is our womb center? It's right in that abdomen. And so instead of healing the trauma, I didn't know how, my body just built up more and more and more energy and density around this trauma that was stuck in my abdomen. So I couldn't heal it. And I just was building, building, building more. That's what happens when we refuse to address the root cause of our imbalances. They just keep growing. Although you might be able to suppress it temporarily with this pharmaceutical drug, or you might be able to suppress it temporarily with surgical removal, it's not the core. And so I'm standing firm, and I'm saying this out loud to all of you. I've said it to my family, that I'm doing this the natural way. I feel like we should be able to be balanced in our bodies, in our weight, and live a natural life that is full and fulfilling. And if you want to splurge on the gelato, it's not going to blow your diet. It's not going to like ruin things for you. When I started energy healing, you know what my goal was? I'm very good at getting my goals. I once had a goal. I knew that I was supposed to live on a tropical island my whole life. And here I am. Aloha beaches. And now I'm doing it. So when I set my mind to something, I do it. And so I'm saying this to be accountable. But when I first started energy healing, I said, I wanted to be able to heal people in 1 second. Do a complete healing on their body in 1 second. Linear time. And guess what I can do now? I could do the 1 second sessions. Yes, it's many hours happening behind the veil of work for you, but I have gotten it to the point where I can do it like that. That was my goal, and here I am. And if clients, if we were completely ready and open to receive 100% healing and let it all go, we could instantly be transformed like that. But the problem is we're attached to our trauma. We're attached to our fat. That's my fat. My body is overbalanced, you know, overweight. We start owning that. Just like I caught myself saying my allergies. I'm like, no, allergy symptoms. These are not mine. I'm not owning them anymore. They're not part of me. I'm not going to claim them. And a huge issue that I found with those that were for myself and those suffering with Lyme disease, chronic Lyme disease, is that it becomes our identity. We own it. It's us. Like, I'm Raylene with Lyme disease. I used to tell people that, like, I have Lyme disease. And I owned it as part of me. And when I started healing, I shifted it. I stopped owning it. I cleared the false core beliefs that were making me believe that I could never get better and this was just how I was and I was stuck like this and I was going to die like this. I cleared all of that mental programming and the trauma behind it. And I started saying, I'm healing. I'm healing. And then I started saying my body is healed. And guess what? My body is literally healed. So your mentality, your mindset, what you're programming, your water and your body matters. All of it matters. This is how we get back to the core. So if you're on board for this, connect with the weight wall session tomorrow. Share with your friends. It's less than your Weight Watchers, your weight protocols. It's way less. Even if you level up, it's cheaper. Leveling up adds 3 days. I'd highly recommend it because what do? I work on you for 24 hours and then 24 hours, 24 hours, 24 hours. You're multiplying your session by 3 days. And so we can go a lot deeper because often our bodies say, no, I can only do this much right now. Have you ever been tapped out? I've had too much energy exchange. This place is too overwhelming for me. We've gone deep enough for today. I need to sleep on it and rest, and then I can come back fresh tomorrow. That's the power of leveling up your session. We can go a lot deeper that way. So there's part of my weight journey, and I'm in it with you. I'm working on it. I would love to let go, release 20 pounds, but I'd be happy with 10 or 15. And I found also, for some of you mommies out there, you might still be carrying weight for your children. I found that I am still carrying 12 pounds for my daughter, Briella. And you know what? I don't consent to carrying that for her anymore. I created a little energy chamber and I was like, I'm going to put this extra energy and weight up here for you. And I will harmonize and align it to whatever you want when you're ready to receive it. But I am not carrying it and I do not consent to carrying it on my physical body. I am carrying 5 pounds of unhealed inner child trauma extra in my body. By losing Grace and dealing with child loss, what did it do? It triggered this inner child trauma within me to surface and start packing on the pounds. So where, what is your extra weight coming from? If you know how to muscle test, you can start asking, you know, am I carrying any extra weight for my children? You're 18, time to carry that load for yourself now. Or sign them up for the weight wall session and let me support them if that's the most aligned session. How do we do this? One step at a time. A lot of you, if you've suffered from child loss or have had that in your past timelines, you might be carrying and holding the weight. I noticed that after I lost Grace through a miscarriage, I was so afraid of losing her that I started holding on to energy, holding it into my body because I felt like a failure for letting her go. And I remember sitting in labor for hours as I was miscarrying, trying to hold on with everything in my body, like, hold on, do not let her go. I want to hold her in me and keep her safe. She was already gone, but my body was like, I was programming my body to not let go. And so when I had Briella, we went to 42 weeks in the pregnancy. My body did not want to let her go because I was afraid. It was trauma. And then after I gave birth to her, guess what? I'm still carrying all of my birth weight in my body because of trauma. I'm ready to let it go. I want to let it go. I'm going to let it go. So join me on this if it aligns for you. So there can be all these factors when we're addressing the root cause. And it's not a quick cover up. Next session for Tuesday is prions. Prions are bioweapons created by your pharmaceutical companies that love you so much. They link into severe imbalances in our bodies. Pins and needles, hallucinations, personality changes, pain, spine pain, brain fog, dementia, muscle aches and pains, Alzheimer's, so much more. The reviews and feedback I've received from this session are really incredible. For clients coming in with random pains and somehow on their assessment, it said, you need to take prions, or they just felt led to take the session. And now their 20-year spine pain is gone. Their chronic issue is now gone. So we have our world talks very little about prions, which are misfolded, proteinaceous, infectious particles. And they cause this chain reaction of mutations in our body, of proteins. It is the root of mad cow diseases and wasting diseases in humans and animals. What is dementia and Alzheimer's? They are wasting diseases. What is muscle atrophy, muscle dystrophy? It is a wasting disease. Yet somehow we have all these diagnoses for animals, but when it comes to humans, we just happen to forget that these exist in the human race. And they were planted on purpose to make you sick and lifelong customers of the pharmaceutical industry. So they can drain out all of your energy and resources, and you can become a slave trapped in the matrix for life. Miserable and sick. Depressed. Cut off from your higher self, cut off from source. So if you're ready to reclaim yourself and get this energy out of your body, quantum healing is the only way that I know to release these effectively. And we're not just releasing them. We are releasing the root cause of why they can attach to begin with. So if you are exposed in the future, the goal is that they have no hold on you. They cannot touch you or stick in you. You can be flooded with prions and nothing happens. That is the power of true root level healing. When we're not covering it up, we're taking care of why it can attach to begin with. Let's go into the chat and do a live clearing. Let's connect in for one of the hubbies here. Dawn, your partner gives permission. Yes. What can we do? Spleen and appendix attachment overlay, cord, connected to mother, but it was inherited from your father's family line. So these can get a little tricky sometimes. Your body's ready to let that go. This is impacting your immune system and your connection to source at the root. Thank you for letting me connect today. Hey, Amy. Marcia says, thank you, thank you. I'm so grateful for the clearing. Happy to support. Elizabeth says this retrograde has been happy for her. Great. I'm so happy to hear it. Sean says it is explained or explains why her husband has been sleeping so much. My boys too. Everybody's been like, I might have one up there right now sleeping. They've been so sleepy lately. Give yourself permission to rest. All right, let's kind of, okay, I see some of your comments and I'm going to get off on a tangent. If we have time, we'll talk about it. All right, let's connect in with Kim. Permission. Thanks, Kim, for connecting today. There's a sabotage anchor hidden in your spleen, connected to your inner child self-worth through the time-space continuum, which means it's connected to other timelines or past lives, and it's feeding on your energy. Anytime we have a quarter connection, it's pulling on us. We're connected to that timeline. Whatever has happened there is happening there. So your body's ready to let that go. Give yourself 3 days of processing, Kim. That was 23 hours of linear time work, but it happened in a split second behind the veil because my work and my intention came to life in fruition, just like the wait is going to happen.